Researchers at Michigan State University are working on making biofuels, like ethanol, more available to consumers. Their hope is to replace petroleum-based fuels with more environmentally friendly fuels made from renewable sources.
Well, we do have about 14 billion gallons or so of ethanol from corn, but it probably can't grow much more after that. That's roughly 10% by volume of our total gasoline. But we just don't have enough corn to replace half or, you know, two-thirds or 100% of our gasoline pool. To do that, we have to rely on plant material that's not food. So we're talking about grasses, wood chips, straws, sawdust, parts of municipal waste, converting that into liquid fuels.
But turning non-food crops into fuel that can run your car is more complicated and more expensive. Ethanol is made by fermenting sugars, but the sugars in trees and grasses are much harder to get to.
We have to subject the plant material to conditions that it doesn't experience in nature. What we use is hot, concentrated ammonia. Think really hot, really concentrated Windex is what we use, and that breaks open enough of the plant cell structure so that the enzymes, these are biological molecules that attack those sugars and make something that's fermentable sugar out of them.
MSU has been given a $3 million federal grant to make the process commercially viable. The plan is to take some of the risk out of starting a biofuels operation and give investors more confidence in renewable energy production.
I'm sure that our processes today are better than $4 a gallon, but there's a whole lot of impediments in the way be taking something from the laboratory and getting it to your corner gas station. And our fuel market, for example, is not open. You can't just put a new fuel on the market. The people that control the infrastructure, the requirements of the engines and so forth, say such and such fuels and not others. So that's something we have to work on. We have to be able to have more flex fuel vehicles that can accept a wider range of fuels. And we have to have the fueling and the infrastructure that allows that kind of fuel to be delivered to the customer.
For WKAR Public Media, I'm Rob South with reWorking Michigan.